Welcome back. In less than 3 weeks, Hokulea set sail on the international portion of her voyage around the world. First up, Tahiti, about a 25 to 30 day journey. Now tonight, we look at how wayfinding non-instrument navigation works and ask, how do you navigate to Tahiti? Turns out, it takes more than just the stars to guide Hokulea exploring Earth. Watching the brightest star in our sky rise and set generally tells a navigator east or west. But as night falls, the heavens fill with thousands of points of light. They too rise east, set west, but to harness this astronomical chaos and pull them to an earthly order, the navigator uses a star compass. Mao and his ancestors for centuries before him used this fiercely protected teaching tool to organize the sky. It is the foundation of celestial navigation.
So it is a beautiful gift that he gave to us, because I believe that the Hawaiians had a star compass.
Adapted to Hawaii and concepts of math and science, on the ocean, a star compass becomes a canoe's 360-degree horizon, divided into 32 parts or houses where stars live. Navigators memorize about 220 stars and their houses.
The best way to prepare academically for navigating to Tahiti would be memorizing the houses that these stars we're going to see will be rising from or setting into.
And it gives you bearing and direction, and it centers you.
Star lines based on Hawaiian stories help to further make sense of the stars. For example, Ka'iwi Kuamo'o, the backbone of the lizard. From the star Hokupa'a, the North Star, to the Big Dipper, Hokulea, Hikinalia, to the Southern Cross, whose stars point south to Tahiti.
When you teach that to a child or to a crew member, they remember the story and then they remember the patterns in the skies.
For all the emphasis on stars, and they are important, you can't navigate without them. Thompson says on average, navigators see and use the stars only about 20% of the time.
When you don't have the stars or when it's daytime and the sun is high, you really have to rely on your confidence of your ability to read the waves.
If it's cloudy, read the ocean waves. To Tahiti, waves generated by the easterly trades. Not always easy in choppy seas or when you can't see them, when it's solid cloud cover and at night.
Like Ma would say, if you can read the wave, you're never lost. So your job, if you're going to Tahiti and you're heading south, you want to have the wave come from the east. If you're looking forward in the canoe, it go through your left foot and come out your right foot. That's how you do it. Have a nice day.
As you think you're approaching land, you look for certain birds.
So every morning they come out from the land to go fish, and then every sunset time they'll go back, generally.
And listen.
The coral reef's lucky you see it. Sometimes we hear the wave before we see the island. All the signs of nature are there to tell you how to find Tahiti. You need to be able to read it.
Navigating isn't just moving toward your destination, but remembering from where you came, how far you've traveled, what direction, and what amount of time, all without watches or instruments, all without sleep, maybe 2 hours a day taken in short 10 to 20 minute cat naps.